Starlink is a new internet network powered by a satellite feature that can be used on a global level. The network is operated by SpaceX, which provides satellites that Starlink uses to supply internet connectivity wherever you are on Earth. SpaceX began launching satellites for the Starlink project back in 2019. In September 2022, Starlink consists of over 3,000 manufactured satellites in low Earth orbit that communicate with devices on the Earth's surface. As of June 2022, Starlink had over 500,000 subscribers. In 2019, the U.S. Federal Communications Commission sent notifications to International Telecommunication when several astronomers raised their concerns about how the satellite constellations affected ground-based astronomy in a negative way, and how the satellites further will affect an already overloaded orbital environment. SpaceX believed that they have done as much as they can regarding the question, meaning that the satellites do not have a direct negative effect regarding such matters. The satellites are also equipped with crypto-powered Hall effect thrusters that cause the satellites to go out of orbit when they are used up. In addition, the satellites are designed to avoid collisions based on uplink tracking data. The idea of constellations of low Earth orbit satellites came as early as the mid-1980s by the Strategic Defense Initiative. At the time, the idea was that with the help of the satellites, weapons could be sent up to intercept ballistic missiles at short notice. During the 1990s, however, these ideas changed and research and development for these types of communication satellites began. However, all those working on the projects went out of business when the dot-com bubble burst, partly because the launch costs for those types of projects were incredibly high at the time. In the middle of 2004, the then newly formed company SpaceX stepped in and bought up shares in Surrey Satellite Technology, which had then begun work on expanding the internet into space. In 2008, however, SpaceX sold its share and ended the collaboration with Surrey Satellite Technology. In 2016, SpaceX trademarked the name Starlink, a name inspired by the book, The Fault in Our Stars. In connection with opening up the development facility in Redmond in 2015, Elon Musk said that there is a significant unmet demand worldwide for low-cost bandwidth capacity. As of September 2022, SpaceX has over 2,300 operational Starlink satellites in orbit, and over 500,000 active subscribers. In the fall of 2022, SpaceX will launch 53 satellites per Falcon 9 flight. Starlink received approval in 2020 from Innovation, Science and Economic Development Canada to have satellites in low Earth orbit, and with that approval received a federal subsidy worth over $885 million to support rural internet connectivity. 2 years later, in August 2022, the aid was withdrawn as it was believed that Starlink had not demonstrated the ability to deliver what was promised when the aid was awarded. Starlink has appealed the verdict and believes that the requirements have been rewritten and are impossible to live up to. Negotiations are ongoing as we speak. On October 1, SpaceX announced that Sanjay Bhargava, who was part of Elon Musk's PayPal team, would lead Starlink's venture in India. Barely 3 months after that, Bhargava left for personal reasons, after the Indian government ordered SpaceX to stop selling pre-orders for Starlink services in the country. SpaceX landed its first contract for passenger shipping services as Royal Caribbean Group landed Statralink Internet for Freedom of the Seas, and plans to offer the service on 50 ships under its Royal Caribbean International, Celebrity Cruises, and Silver Sea Cruises brands. In the air, Starlink services can be used when flying private jet charter flights in the U.S., and to and from Hawaii from 2023 on Trans-Pacific flights. SpaceX has said that the main interest in getting Starlink up and running is that they need the revenue from the satellite-based service to fund their plans to colonize Mars. In addition, SpaceX has long-term plans that it is through Starlink that will make it possible to have internet on Mars for the first inhabitants who live there. In early 2018, the Space Development Agency was formed by then Undersecretary of Defense, Michal D. Griffin, which was a part of an initiative by the Trump administration to revive the Strategic Defense Initiative. The organization works to speed up the development of new military space activities with a focus on satellite platforms with low Earth orbit. In October, the Space Development Agency awarded SpaceX with $150 million to develop a luxury Starlink satellite shuttle. The first part of these satellites was scheduled to be launched in September 2022, but the date has been moved forward to mid-December 2022. The technology in these satellites will first and foremost be used for tracking. In order for a country to be able to offer Starlink services, the International Telecommunication Union must first approve the agreement, and further that they be granted by each country's national communications regulatory authorities. Currently, SpaceX are focusing on the countries from which they gain the most profit from when it comes to business operation, and the economic aspects are decisive. In September, the services are available in approximately 40 countries, but there are applications from 116 countries that want to connect to the global networks.